One, you take the sample of ketone, that is acetone, you add metadienitrobenzene. You have already seen metadienitrobenzene in class 11 when you test for nitrogen in organic compound. This, then you add sodium hydroxide. Or you take sodium nitroprusside solution and add sodium hydroxide. So I will show the two tests. One metadienitrobenzene, another sodium nitroprusside test. So metadienitrobenzene test. What is the test for metadienitrobenzene? You take first acetone in a sample. You take the acetone. This is acetone. You add some metadienitrobenzene. Say, this is metadienitrobenzene. You have seen it. Add it. Take it. Then you add few drops sodium hydroxide solution. Sodium hydroxide solution. What color obtain? Purple color. The jala moto wrong is violet color. Yes, sir. So this is the test. You observe this color. So for the test for ketone, you take the sample. No, sodium nitroprusside. দেখুন স্যার এইরকম ক্ষেত্রে একটু বড় করে ধরুন এরকম টাইপের ইন দা টেস্ট ফর কিটোন ইউ টেক দা লিকুইড স্যাম্পল ইন এ টেস্ট টিউব ইউ টেক দা লিকুইড স্যাম্পল ইন এ টেস্ট টিউব ইউ অ্যাড মেটাডাইনাইট্রোবেনজিন দিস ইজ মেটাডাইনাইট্রোবেনজিন এন্ড ইউ অ্যাড সোডিয়াম হাইড্রোক্সাইড ইউ সি দিস এ পার্পল অর ভায়োলেট কালার ইজ অবটেইন ঠিক আছে This is the test for keto group. You note the color. Very simple test. Another test is the sodium nitroprusside test. In the sodium nitroprusside test, you take first you prepare the sodium nitroprusside. You know sodium nitroprusside since it is sodium salt, so it must be soluble in water. This is sodium nitroprusside. You shake it to prepare the solution. But in the final exam, the sodium nitroprusside solution will be present in the lab. Sodium nitroprusside, you take in a test tube, take first the acetone solution. Take first acetone solution. This is acetone. Now you add sodium nitroprusside. To the acetone you add sodium nitroprusside. Then you add sodium hydroxide solution. This is sodium hydroxide. What do you obtain? A red color. So you take the liquid sample. Then you add sodium nitroprusside. Then you add sodium hydroxide. A red color is obtained. Deep red color is obtained. So this is the two important tests for keto group. This test cannot be shown by aldehyde group. Two for DNP test or sodium bisulfite test is a common test for carbonyl group. But these two tests, one, first you take the acetone solution, then you add metadienitrobenzene, then add few drops of sodium hydroxide. A purple or violet color is obtained. That is confirm the keto group. Another, you take the acetone, then you take the sodium nitroprusside solution, then you add sodium hydroxide, a red color is obtained. So these are the two important tests for keto group. So these are the three functional group I have shown you, first alcohol, then aldehyde, then ketone. The last one is the acetic acid, that is the carboxyl acid group. Carboxyl acid group have two important tests, three important tests. Number one, you can judge it by adding the indicator, say blue litmus, it turns blue litmus red. number 2 acidification test and number 3 sodium bicarbonate test. If you take sodium bicarbonate solution, then carboxylic acid give effervescence of sodium bicarbonate. So first we take the acetic acid. Now the last group which is organic compound is the carboxylic acid test, C-OOH group. We take the sample of vinegar, that is acetic acid. You know, it is a vinegar-like smell. You take small amount of sample in a test tube first and you add blue litmus solution. This is the blue litmus solution and indicator. What do you observe? The blue litmus turns red. If you add one drop blue litmus solution, say blue litmus turns light red color. It is not deep red because acetic acid is a very weak acid. Blue litmus turns red, it confirms the presence of acidic group in the sample. So this is the one test, very simple test. You take the sample in a test tube and add blue litmus solution. If it turns red, then it is the carboxylic acid group. But you cannot confirm whether it is the carboxylic acid or inorganic acid. Now in the another test tube, you take the sample solution, add sodium bicarbonate solution, NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate solution. You know that all types of carboxylic acid or inorganic acid evolve CO2 gas. See this, effervescence of CO2 gas. This is the effervescence. You observe this, some gas is evolved. This is known as effervescence. This type of gas, this is the effervescence of gas. This gas is CO2 gas. So if effervescence begins, then you can predict that this effervescence starts. This is due to the formation of CO2 molecule. Acetic acid reacts with sodium bicarbonate to form sodium acetate, water and CO2 gas. This CO2 gas bubbles out. This is known as effervescence. So effervescence of gas confirm the presence of carboxylic group in the compound. So this is the second test. A third test is the esterification test that I have already done in the case of alcohol. What is the test? You first take the ethyl alcohol, you first take the vinegar or given liquid, then you add the ethyl alcohol. After addition of ethyl alcohol, you add few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. This is concentrated sulfuric acid. With the help of a dropper, you add few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid. Then you cover the mouth of the test tube. You cover the mouth of the test tube in this way. With the help of a paper or this newspaper, you cover the mouth of the test tube in this way, then take the water bath. This in the next video I will show the by showing the burner. Water gas, you heat it for 5 minutes. After heating on a water bath of the sample, the ester is formed because the reaction needs some heat energy. Acetic acid plus ethyl alcohol, they react together to form ethyl acetate. Then you take another beaker. You take another beaker containing some water. You open the mouth and add the solution in the beaker containing water and observe the smell. If a fruity smell is obtained, then it is a acidification test, that is acetic acid is present. So this is the three tests for acetic acid. Number one, you take the sample solution, liquid sample, add few drops of litmus paper, blue litmus. It turns red, or you can take the blue litmus paper, it also turns red. Number two, you take the sample and add sodium bicarbonate solution, effervescence of CO2 gas. And number three, you take the sample, add ethyl alcohol, few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid, cover the mouth with the paper, heat on a water bath, after heating, take the solution and pour the solution on a beaker containing water. And you observe the smell. A fruity smell confirm the acidification test. So these are the three important tests for acetic acid proof. Dear student, you must remember that in the final examination, when you write, say, out of four functional group, you have given any one of the sample group. Say you have obtained the aldehyde group. Then you must write the three positive tests for aldehyde. Say failing solution test, tolerance reagent test and Schiff reagent test, and you must write one negative test of alcohol, ketone and carboxylic acid. Say you add ceric ammonium nitrate, no dead precipitate, alcohol is absent. You add blue litmus solution, no dead color, carboxylic acid is obtained. You add metadinitrobenzene and NaOH, no dead color is formed, no violet color is formed, so ketone is obtained. That is, in the writing pattern, you must write three important positive tests for the functional group that you have obtained and one negative test each of the other group. And it will be better if you write the equation in the observation column or inference column. Say you gave the failing solution test. So write the equation of the reaction. That is CH3CHO plus 2Cu plus 2 plus 5OH minus gives Cu2O plus CH3COO minus. And that precipitate, because this will be better for the full marks obtained. Okay. So this is the first video class of the practical on the basis of the functional group of organic compound. In the next video, I will send about the volumetric titration, mainly two volumetric titration. One is potassium permanganate and more salt, another is potassium permanganate and oxalic acid. So in the last year, potassium permanganate and more salt has come. So in the coming year, probably potassium permanganate and oxalic acid, that will be shown in the next video class. Okay.